That's bugged out, bro. This shit is super weird.
We in here, we in here. Come over, go back up high. Back up, yeah, yeah. Alright, shit. Getting pretty good. Alright, shalom, shalom. First and foremost, before we get started, as always, we're going to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai, Hashem, Rakakadash. Also, double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone. And salutations to all you brothers out there. Another Saturday, another day to prophesy.
All right,
you know, creating a side camp, that's the main camp over there. And, you know, we're just going to hop in the spirit, man. You know, if your brother's got any precepts, anything on your mind. All right. Ah, man. Well, Jake bugged out the goddamn mind, man. I just wanted to say that real quick. Before we started the live stream, man, you had all these Jakes, you know, piling up over there, smoking their squares, talking about a whole lot of nothing, you know? Women were literally with their asses completely out.
That's right.
You know? Our people are a bunch of degenerates, man.
That's right.
Got it out.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 4, verse 22.
Yep.
For my people is foolish, they have not known me. They are sodden children, and they have none understanding. They are wise to do evil, but to do good they have no knowledge. Like the elder brother was just going into, man. Jake is out here smoking darts. You know, all these women out here walking around half naked, you know, bouncing around from man to man out in the open. Nobody cares. No, these little children don't know how to fucking act. They not being monitored by no adults at all. They outside, just outside. You know? Yeah, it's a whole manner of negativity.
That's why there's all these children kidnappings, man.
That's right.
Abduction. You'll literally, this is a common thing in the hood, man. You'll see little random kids. When I say kids, I'm talking about 3, 4, 5 year olds. Running up and down the streets, like, not being monitored, as the brother said. Their mom is getting, you know, banged.
Pound
town. Yeah. All right? She's getting fucking thrashed, all right, by Pookie and the gang.
That's it.
Okay? The dad is, they don't even know who their dad is.
Yeah.
All right?
Yeah.
And they're just, you know, out there to fend for themselves.
That's right, man. And we're talking about, this is, I don't know how it is. It's probably like this in, like, New York and L.A., too. You know, but we're talking about children walking around on main streets, man.
Yep.
Children walking around on a street similar to the one that we teaching on right now, where it's a 5-lane road and these kids crossing the street by themselves, going to the store by themselves. And Ishmael don't get no fuck. These Ishmaelites selling blunts to little kids, all that shit.
Everything.
Man.
You going next
liquor
door
to little kids? They don't care.
Yeah.
At 9 o'clock in the morning, man. I seen them on 12, man. Oh. You know. Hey, like you said, again, her black back blown out by Pookie. Hey, now you got Smart Pookie now, man, blowing out their back. That's another, you know, first you used to worry about your, you worry about your child, that old man. Now you got to worry about old-ass women looking at your kids now, man.
That's right.
You know, it's like it's getting waxing worse and worse.
That's right. Man. That's right. And when you and see, the thing about that, all of these behaviors are just demons that's on people. And the thing about it is that, you know, when somebody got a demon on them, especially the Mo demon, but this is really with anything that put a demon on you, man. The demon's job is to go and get people that's not doing this shit to do it. So, for example, you dealing with a stud, the woman dealing with a stud, or even because a lot of these pookie niggas that you think thugs really be on the down low, they just, they deal with chicks from time to time too, but they still be dealing with men and young boys on the regular, man.
That's because they root beasts, man. They they just deal with anything that got a heart, man.
That's it.
You know?
And so these niggas, they show up, and now the demon make them want to make the kid get the demon on them.
Yeah.
You know? So now they start doing shit to the kid.
And the majority, and this is a known fact, you've had, you know, statistics, interviews, right? The majority of people are homosexuals were sexually abused when they were children.
Right.
And then even a lot of the pedophiles, right? The majority of them, they had things happen to them when they were a child.
Hey,
Hey, it's funny. I just put it in the group me yesterday. Remember that show, To Catch a Predator, man?
Okay,
they
yes,
canceled it, man. You know what I'm saying? They canceled it because of some lawyer, some corporate lawyer got caught up, man. So he was like, hell no, we got to be done with this goddamn show, man.
And they put he offed himself.
Yeah.
He offed himself on the spot, and they canceled the show. That's why you don't see, was it Chris Hansen?
They demonized Chris him, too.
He was hilarious.
He was a demon. But yeah, they criminalize, demonize him too, and to make his word not accountable anymore, man. That was a good show, man. They were catching a gang of Edomites, the top level Edomites they were catching, man. You know,
like this show's going too far now.
Yeah, you know, because this is what Esau does. See, Esau is a cunning hunter, right? Yep. So he'll put a show like that, like, see, we're doing something about it. See, we got the show. So he's doing his shit. You know what I'm saying? This dude is cunning. Can I get a preset right there? Look at some of the higher people. This is Baruch chapter 2, verse 30. For I knew that they would not hear me, because it is a stiff-necked people. But in the land of their captivities, they shall remember themselves, and that's the elect. All right? And the reason why I brought the Edomites up, man, because our people follow the ways of Edom, man. They like, fuck it. If you can't beat them, join them.
That's why they're doing the things that they're doing, because this behavior is really Edomite behavior.
That's right.
All right? Because remember, black culture originated with Esau, okay?
That's
it. Started with the serpent. All right, down to Cain.
That's it.
Now down to the Edomites, the so-called white man. All right, this is Edomite culture, to be honest. You know, raping children, okay? So, and having orgies. A woman bouncing from man to man. That's the original slut was the white woman.
That's it.
Bro, I remember as a youngster growing up in Chicago, Jake would go deal with the snow because it was easier.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Keisha was kind of had a little reserve, like, hell no, that's nasty. You better ask your mama to suck your dick. Then they would have the show Girls Gone Wild. They would show that shit for anyone. It was just them doing that shit. Eve, like, nah, I ain't doing that stupid shit. Nah, Eve, then they got into with Mardi Gras. They started doing it, and slowly but surely, Eve then overtook fucking Seesaw, man.
They done put that rap demon on black bitches, man. Yep. And they done took it to a whole other level, man.
Like I said this to Alec Karab, man, many a times. That 90s era, bro, you know, things were happening before, but that 90s era with that gangster rap, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Early 2000s rap, put a fucking super demon on Jake, bro.
Yeah.
Real talk. Yeah. All the tribes are all messed up because of fucking rap, bro.
That's it.
Real talk. And that's why these, the CEOs of, like, you know, Sony, all right, I can't think of, what is another one, but I can,
Def Jam,
Interscope,
Warner,
yeah, all
they,
that.
They pay all this money, which is really still peanuts how much they make, but they, give all this money to these rappers because it destroys Jake, and then, you know, we all know who owns, you know, these, record label
that's
companies,
right?
It's the small headers.
That goes to Revelation 12 and 10, man. Where the accuser of our brethren, man. Look at them. They're doing all this rap music stuff. They just keep on sending. Hey, how are these young people, man? You know, trying to accuse us, man. Categorizing us.
Yeah.
That's why a motherfucker can come from another country and they kind of scoot away from you because they've been told through the media how Esau just demonized this. All this shit is his. Everything you touch, see, and hear, and feel, he owns it.
But then a lot of times, especially when we're talking about Jake's coming over here, like for these refugee situations, or even Hamites, you know, a lot of these Hamites come over here, and they got liaisons set up in America, Edomite liaisons, that basically assimilate these people that come from these other countries to American society, and a part of these jobs way motherfuckers away from trying to go deal around Jake, you know?
Hey, I'm going to tell you this, man. When I was young, man, my mother used to get out here right down the street on 83rd. And you didn't see, this is like probably early 80s, you didn't see Ishmaelite or so-called Arabs. You didn't see them. You didn't see, you probably had like one Moab, and that was Chinese food and shit. Bro, everybody, it was Jake owning everything, man. You know what I'm saying? And Jake was doing something, so what they did was they brought Esau, cunning hunter as he is, he brought all those other countries in for our immigrants to weed out Jake.
This office.
To weed out Jake so Jake won't have no ownership since you go bet. This is what the Psalms 83 come into effect, man. They made a tumult against us, man. You know? All the, I bet you go down this plaza right here, man. Ain't barely no Jake's there, man.
Look at the
only
name of the stores.
Yeah.
Know, that's what you know.
All that. Over. Yeah. All that.
Metro, PCS, that's all. It's
yeah. Good, they keep us in servitude, man. Then you have Keisha in there having a baby by an Israelite.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? For some pretty hair.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
You know?
They definitely be on that.
Hey, man, we are at the bottom of the barrel. That's what we mean in the fucking barrel, man.
Yeah, man. But it's for a reason.
Yeah, I was in Baruch 2 and 30. For I knew that they would not hear me because it is a stiff-necked people, but in the land of that captivity, they shall remember themselves. And that's why we love the narrative of the elect, man, because we're going to be taken out of all, Lord willing, we are their number, out of all of this madness, man. And they shall praise me in the land of their captivity. Man, that's America, man. Alright, aka Babylon, and think upon my name. Alright, and return from their stiff neck and from their wicked deeds. But they shall remember the ways of their fathers which sinned before the Lord. Alright, so hey, that's what we're doing, and we're trying to call on to our people, so called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, man, to repent, come back so that you can escape the wrath of the Lord that's coming, man, because it's not.
That's right.
Our people, majority of them, They want to continue to stay here. It's a big party.
Yeah.
You know?
This is what we're doing. It's boring to them.
Yeah. Righteousness is boring to them. And we were talking about this, I think about 2 weeks ago. Thomas Ward, he mentioned his aunt, right? She was from Iowa. Out there in this point, you know, they were quiet out there. Peaceful, you know, everyone got their own little space and all that. And she would say that she wants to move back to Chicago because it's too quiet. It's too boring.
I've heard that million times. It's too quiet.
And we were just, you know, talking about it, how they want to hear the gunshots.
Yeah.
They want to hear the ambulances. They want to hear people on their ATVs blasting music.
That's right.
They want to hear the goddamn bus. They want to hear the local, you know, heroin addict crackhead just be screaming. That's what they want to be around, man.
Yeah.
And then Jake is literally, if a brother can get it, Deuteronomy 28, they're stricken with madness. Even if they're so-called, okay, going to work,
yeah,
okay, you know, they got the house, they're able to cook, do all these things, they're still speaking with madness because they actually love this place, a place that's designed to kill them.
Hey, actually, this place is really a prison house, man.
Yeah.
You know, this is like a penitentiary, but these people are in jail in their minds, man. They can't get enough of Babylon, man. Hey, man, I think the Chinese got next.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 28. The Lord shall smite thee with madness and blindness and astonishment of heart. And thou shalt grope in the noon days as the blind gropeth in darkness, and thou shalt not prosper thy ways, and thou shalt be only oppressed and spoiled evermore, and no man shall save thee.
Exactly. So it said that the Lord is going to strike us with madness, okay? And that we're what? Going to be oppressed?
Right.
All right? Hey, these are the curses that the Lord has set upon us.
See?
And our people love it so, as the scriptures talk about. Okay? And say, instead of returning to Yahweh Bashim Yahshai, they actually wax worse and worse, as the brother brought out in Jeremiah.
That's
come on,
it.
I think you brought it out.
Come.
You know?
Amen.
So that's why it's like real quick. That's why the Lord, you know, it's all good actually. Like, that was, make my final point. That's why the Lord, he's got to eliminate the 2/3. They can't be rehabilitated. You can't do nothing with this with these people.
Yeah.
It's like, all right, man, I try to beat you. I try to talk to you. I try to counsel you. Like, there's nothing working. It doesn't matter what, you know, avenue, what angle I come from. I mean, it's just you keep rebelling.
That's
so
right.
I got to destroy you.
That's right. Like your brother said, you know, a lot of Jakes, man, it don't matter. It don't matter what situation that you end up finding yourself in, because the job is already done. You you already mentally destroyed, and you ain't, and you're not looking for the more. It's like Jacob, for example, if Jacob grew up in the hood, man, and end up making a bunch of money, or and you don't even necessarily got to be a millionaire or nothing, but just get a good job where you can go live somewhere nice, and you go in these niggas' house, the house be nice, and you open the refrigerator, and these niggas still eat like they live on the block, man.
You got Jake, what's his new job on me?
I was just about to bring that
this
shit
up. This dude actually came from a so-called good household, both parents, they had good jobs. I think he grew up in the suburbs. This dude's still trying to live. He's trying to be thug life right now, bro.
Trying to be a crip. This nigga's in the NBA.
What the fuck is wrong with you, bro? You make millions of dollars. You're not about this, dude. I can see it in your face, man.
Not at all, man.
That's the truth. Like, you're not about it, bro. You're not about thug life. Trust me. I know you're playing with your guns. You're on IG. You got dreads. You know, you think it's cute. But, no, bro. You're not about this, man.
That's what you call spit with madness, man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's something like that when I get that movie on ATL, man. Bro, I was trying to be...
And then, but it go back to what we were saying. He did a diligent search to find out how to mentally put Jake in the bag. The Lord allowed him to show how to put Jake in the bag, man. And that shit with ATL, that shit is a real... Niggas really like that in real life, man. This little bitch, and that bitch actually, he might, her dad, Amalek, Lauren London. But, this bitch end up in the movie. Her daddy, a rich millionaire black motherfucker. And this bitch taking field trips to the hood to go to the skating rink and shit. And this nigga, T.I. end up starting to deal with the bitch. And the bitch buying and all that shit. And this nigga go to the bitch house and find out she rich. And now the nigga don't want to fuck with her no more.
Yeah.
Like, me and Murph was talking about that shit. I said, man, nigga, that sound like, that's great. Get some money.
Yeah, sure.
Shit. This bitch drive a big body Benz and all that. This bitch pulling up to the crib in a big body Benz, man. Yeah. And this nigga was crying because she lied on some whole shit. But see, that's how Jake really is, man.
Yeah.
And it was a double programming because T.I. acting like that, that's how a woman would act. And even a woman would actually be happy in that situation.
Yeah, because women look for power.
You know what I'm saying?
They see that.
This nigga, these niggas, but when you want to be a proper individual, when you want to do things right, man, Jake is programmed to stalk you for that, man.
Hey, that's funny you say that, man. I remember being in school. You know, I remember in school, you'll know, like, all the answers to teachers. Yeah, you raise your hand, and you hear that one motherfucker.
Yeah.
You're like, damn, motherfucker, y'all mad because I know the fucking answers. So what you do when you go, I was student number Chase, man. I ain't seen these songs until I went to high school, man. So what you do, you don't raise your hand no more.
Yeah.
Try to kind of dumb yourself down. As a kid, you know, you trying to be in, you know, fit in and shit, which that fucked up, so that's training you to read. You know what I'm saying? Motherfuckers in your class fuck you because you get good grades, man. That's some bug out shit, man.
Yeah, man, a lot of these Jakes, they got that spirit of slavery. Of chattel slavery still on them right now, man. That's some chattel slave shit. The nigga look like he too smart, so now we all finna gang up on this nigga and snitch on him so that we don't get in trouble. That's a carry over from the chattel slave mentality, bro.
And that goes into also too, where you have a virgin, right? She's in school. Just say she a virgin, she a sophomore, and you got all the ratchets around her. Hey, there was. But she saying, I want to be a wife and a mother. That's my career I want to be. Hey, they will laugh at the storm, bro.
And none of these bitches ain't going to ever be shit.
No.
All the bitches talking shit ain't even the bitches that's really being doctors and shit. That's what's so funny. I got to
make a point. It's fucked up how Jake, right, is now because, remember, our people, we were the ones who originally taught the heathens, man.
That's right.
We were the ones that had, you know, had all this wisdom, right? And now that, you know, now you look at Jake and it's just like, God damn, is this the people that you're talking about? But I was gonna say, I don't know how it's worded. If brother can maybe pull it up, but talk about how our power is the power of knowledge. Something on those lines, and it comes up, it's not talking. But it talks about how our power is the power of knowledge, man. You know, we're not supposed to be, you know, foolish individuals if we are the children of the Most High who have the power of knowledge. All right? But see, in this society, hey, this scripture even talk about woe unto them that call evil good and good evil, right? Because being so intelligent is a good thing. But in this society, if Jake is smart, that's bad.
Yeah.
And it doesn't matter if you're amongst other Jakes, or if you're amongst Edomites, Siemens, if you're an intelligent Jake, then now that's a threat to them.
That's right.
Yeah, because these people, they got the mindset of evil, man. Who you think you better be, what they call it, the crab in a barrel mentality.
Oh, especially here in Chicago. That's why every famous person that comes from Chicago, they never stay here. This is the worst place when it comes to, like, a Jake, you know, being, say if they get successful, right? You can't, let's team up and let's keep building. Let's get this.
Not here,
not here. That's why. That's why they all move to Atlanta, LA, wherever, you know what I'm saying? Uh-huh. Even New York, they'll get some shit done.
Yeah. Nothing, niggas stay in New York. All them niggas that be famous in New York stay up there, man.
They don't leave.
These niggas, look, man, these niggas in Chicago are on another level of famous. You know? Niggas don't want to work together here. Niggas want to be the one in charge. Everybody's like that.
That's why everybody's got to be cleansed with thermal fire, man.
Did Brother find that by any chance?
No, I didn't.
It's all good. If you guys...
Is it actually power, or did it say God?
It might say God. Check that real quick. If not, it's cool. You know what I'm saying? I can't remember how it's exactly worded. And then whatever precepts you brothers had on deck, I just wanted to get that out. I forgot how it's worded exactly. So forgive me.
I think I got it.
God and knowledge or something
this,
like that?
This is the book of 1 Samuel chapter 2 and verse 3. Talk no more so exceeding proudly. Let not arrogancy come out of your mouth. For Yahweh is a power of knowledge.
Yep, there we go.
And by him actions are weighed.
Okay, so our power is a power of knowledge, man. Okay? And like I mentioned, if we're the sons of the living power, we should be, for lack of words, proud of being intelligent.
Right.
We shouldn't be fools, man. Okay? But we gotta be on a high level. See, that's the problem with our people, man. They're on such a base level that anything that anybody that starts to, excelling, in his life, so to speak, now they want to pull him down. It's crazy, bro. It's crazy. But hey, we're under the curse, man.
I got one. This is Romans 11 and 7. What then? Israel have not obtained that which he seek for. All right, and that's what's that truth, man. Jake out here searching for everything. No justice, no peace. This is the season of what you call them.
We got George Floyd right next to us.
Yeah, you
nigger.
They looking for truth. They look for black excellence. You know what I'm saying? They looking for generational wealth. You know, everything except Yahweh Shem Yahushua, man.
Right.
This is all temporal, what you're looking at, man. Yep. You know, you get, sometimes you'll give the Lord a give you a little, throw you a little bone. But then you still around like, yo, man, this still ain't it, though, man.
That's
you know
right.
what I'm saying? Now we got this truth, man. And now we're being, these bones are being watered now, man. And we're getting the skin bit put back on us, man. You know, sometimes we have bad times. You know, come this truth, you know, bad things start happening. But hey, you like, yo, we got the truth though, man.
Oh, yeah.
You know, continuing. This is Romans 11 and 7 again. What then? Israel have not obtained that which he seek for, but the election have obtained it, and the rest were blinded, man. So we're, Lord willing, we are of that number, that precious number of the election, man. All right? All these other people, they ain't going to get it. All right, that's all we out here for. All right, we're out here making our bodies a living sacrifice. Okay, Jake say this is born doing that. How is it born seeing all the prophecies come into play? Our power working right in front of us, man.
Because at the end of the day, these people want this world to continue.
Yeah.
They're just like Esau, man. They want this wicked kingdom to flourish because let me get real quick, Isaiah 30:1. As the scriptures talk about, they want to end sin, basically, okay? That's why they want to stay here, because when you sin, basically, you're getting a quick fix, right? All right, it's like that quick high.
Right.
It feeds the flesh. But at the end of the day, what happens? It's destructive. It's going to kill you, man. All right? Yep, that slow kill, yep. All right? Got it?
Done. This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 30, and verse 1. Woe to the rebellious children, saith Yahweh, that take counsel, but not of me, and that cover with the covering, but not of my spirit, that they may add sin to sin.
That's why they don't want to return to Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. Because when you follow Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, you have standards, expectations, rules, regulations, all right?
Code.
You have a code, see? Hey, in this world, you can chase the hoes, all right? Do the drugs, you know? Hey, be a killer.
Because Esau gives you false judgment, man. All right, he won't judge a hoe. He won't, you know, judge stuff. So he's false judge, man. You know, but he lock you up for stupid stuff, man. All right, this place is contrary to the scriptures, man. All right, if he ruled this place like they said, this nation of the founding fathers founded under Christianity, and they swear in on the Bible, they make you put your hand on it when you go to court. You know what I'm saying? Hey, when Esau faked it in the 50s, it was like the fabulous 50s or something. He was off like a motherfucker, but it still was like good order. Yeah, you know what I mean? Hey, but even before the what you call it though, civil rights era and all that, Jake was flourishing, man.
Yeah.
Jake was doing real good without that fucking integration bullshit, man. Now look at us, man. Out here through them motherfuckers, man.
Boston and
discovery. Man, you integrated with the fucking devil.
Yeah, man. Jake, man, especially, I've been saying this tomorrow, man. Jakes that are, now of course, you got some Jakes that are in my areas who are so-called cool ones.
Yeah.
But the majority of them, bro, they're worse off, man. Because if you notice, all those Jakes that integrate to the Edomite area, right? Their kids, you know, try to act white and act all weird and shit. The bitches start straightening their hair to the max, bro.
Yeah.
Fucking, they talk all funny.
Yeah.
It's real weird, man. It does a real fucking psychological fuck, you know, to Jake, man.
Yeah.
All right, then all of a sudden, the Jakes that move to those areas start thinking that they're better than everybody else, you know, their own people. It's messed up, bro.
Right.
Then you got the Jakes who are still in the hood when they so-called made it. Now they're talking shit, all right? Don't accept them. It's a fucked up situation.
Well, all you gotta do is repent. You know what I'm saying? Let me finish up with this Romans 11 and 7. It said, and the rest were blinded. Yahweh have given them the spirit of slumber, eyes that they should not see, and ears that they should not hear unto this day. That lets you know this is a live book, man.
Yep.
You know?
So the Lord ultimately blinded the 2/3 of our people. That's why if you are able to understand this truth, you can't take it for granted and be thankful every day. Okay? Because you could be out here too doing the same BS, man. All right, brothers, we came from crazy situation. I'm saying like that, man. Hey, you talked to I'm saying you got some that were heavy in the church, some were gang-banging heavy. All right, somewhere in the fraternity, you know what I'm saying? Man, I'm telling you, you hear brother stories, and you're like, damn, you know? And now they're repenting, returning unto Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. It's a beautiful thing, man. And I think about what I was doing in the world, you know what I mean? I'm lucky the Lord pulled me out when I was pretty young, but man, I'll put it like this, man, if I continue to stay into the world, I'd either be in jail, dead, bro, or fucking just... I would definitely.
Hey, and even like you said, even if you are, let's just say you did do the natural steps to being that American citizen, white picket fence and all that, you still bug the fuck out.
Yeah, shit, my friend. I'll say my brother, right? This guy's the American dream story, right? Came from, grew up in a rough neighborhood, didn't have money, you know, he ends up, getting into college, you know, getting scholarships, joining a fraternity, graduating, getting a job, all these things of getting his master's, right? and you know, moving into a very nice area. Find out this dude recently, he's on anxiety pills, he's all stressed out. He's got a white woman. All right? So he's trying to, you know, assimilate to that. And we kind of look like Edomites, but they're still like, you know, that you know, the difference, you know what I'm saying?
They know you ain't no spirit.
They see your spirit. You know what I mean? Spirit recognizes spirit, man.
All right, so he's still trying to assimilate to that. He's got to laugh at their, you know, jokes when they, you know, make fun of him and shit. And that shit, they be taking a toll on, you know, people.
That'll drive you mad.
You know? Yeah. And no matter what you try to do, you're just not going to ever fit in.
He's in bondage.
Yeah,
man.
Yeah.
It's definitely like
this one. No, it's all good. I was saying, he's in bondage. You know, the people that think they doing good, because once they get up there, they got to stay on that level according to everybody else.
Yeah. But,
you know.
See, I tell Jake all the time, and I actually have experienced this myself, because I've been lived in areas where the whole state is just a bunch of people. So I know what it's like. And, you know, a lot of, especially in Chicago or any of these major cities, you know, Jake is never around Esau when it's abundance of Esau, you know?
Right.
Especially like in Chicago, it's real segregated. Other cities, not so much, but here it is real bad. So like, niggas will just be around niggas their whole life. It's a lot of niggas that, you know, like the Murph was saying, the only Edomites they see is the police,
right,
or some bitch working at a desk or that's a doctor, you know, in authority position. But no, they not really interacting with Edomites, especially in areas where you the one Jake and everybody else in here is an Edomite, to the point where even if these niggas disrespect you, you can't do nothing because all these Edomites just gonna jump you if you hit one of these niggas.
See,
you don't really understand who Esau, you can't have a real full understanding of who Esau is until you go around them, because these Edomites, you know, they real deceptive, man, they real cunning, so they know how to be sweet around niggas when it's not in their favor to be who they really are.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Definitely. But see, when you go in a situation where they don't have to care about what niggas gonna do, you really understand who these people really are, man.
Done.
And a lot of Jakes, they underestimate, and they don't. That's why even when you come out and you tell them Esau is gonna kill you with this, or Esau is gonna make you take that, or put you to death if you don't do it, or whatever the thing that the scriptures say that Esau got coming down the pipe, a lot of these Jakes, they don't think it's real because they ain't never been around Edomites where they was comfortable to just be Edomites, man.
Hey, if I may add on real quick, these Jakes don't know that they have an enemy.
Yeah.
They think their enemy is something like on the block that you down for something more.
Yeah.
I grew up just around Jakes. Just, you know, 5 miles from him, man, you know, and that's all you see. And then when you come into the truth, I study Edom, man. I go, since being in the truth, man, you go on to those pits, bro. I've got to shoot
up. Right, you like, man, she look like that.
God damn, man, these people are through, man. You start going, when you go on like these conservative pages and stuff, because I go on there to find how Esau, you go in these comment sections, how Esau thinks? Oh, shit. You get a plethora of videos to do and just, hey, the scriptures, hey, that's to the point, he is Edom, man. That is the wicked, man.
And like I said, go to Middle America, some places down south.
Shit, even out here in Illinois, shit, go to Southern Illinois.
You go to all of these places.
Indiana right there.
They'll remind you, you're a nigger.
With an R. Boy, I mean, I'm talking about motherfuckers. If you walk in the field and motherfuckers look at you, what is this nigga doing?
Hey, I drive semis, man, so I've been around, man. That's exactly, you walk into a little bar or something, get something to eat, they like, you know, I know I'm Jake, yo, so I'm walking through for my business, ain't nothing ever happened to me. You know what I'm saying? The angels and cameras around. But, hey, man, you have to know, and when E see you, it's a certain way, like, when E see these things, they like, what you got that on you? What is that about? Why is that a gold big rim
of seat? Well, they can see your spirit, bro. Like, people can see the spirit that you got on you, man. And when you don't got the confidence of a nigga, man.
Huh.
They don't like that shit.
Huh. You know.
If we brought out over there, in the main camp, what it say in that book of John, man? Basically, this word brings you to life.
Yeah.
Because now you got the... You got the skin on you.
Yeah.
All right. And the main thing, because you got a lot of Jakes that got the skin. So I want to make a point real quick. But a lot of them don't have the breath of life, man. Get that in Wisdom of Solomon. Talking about wisdom is the breath of life. All right. I'll get it. Brothers can't find it. I think it's the 7th chapter. But it talks about how that wisdom is that breath of life. So now you're living, man. Because like I said, you even got these other camps like the IUICs, the ICKs. They got the skin. They know who they are. They're, I'm Israel. Somebody say, I'm Judah. Oh, I'm Ephraim. Oh, I'm Gad. I'm Issachar. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But they don't really know what is going on, man. Right. They don't have that breath in them. They're not really alive still.
That's right.
All right?
Well, you got it. It's the book of Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 7 and verse 25. For she is the breath of the power of Yahweh and a pure influence flowing from the glory of the Almighty. Therefore, can none undefiled thing fall into her?
Yeah, the main point is how and she's talking about wisdom. Okay, it's the breath of the living power, man, the Most High. All right. See, this is what Jake wants to do all day.
Wait,
oh, he come with what is that metallic fucking paint?
Yeah, that
fucking
that's that two-tone.
Yeah. What is that shit? What size fuel is it old, man?
26.
28.
Fucking yeah. Goddamn, bro.
Hey, but look. Hey, he ride. You ride
the 95 Impala.
Hey, that bitch is like 20,000.
Hell yeah. But Jacob throwed all that shit in his car. Jake probably got at least about 100 racks in that car. Probably,
diligently was working on that.
Yeah, oh, diligently, man. If Jake was to put into the truth like he do folly, man. Hey, man, we've been out of this place where he wasn't written that way. You know what I mean? So, and we just saw the earth. There's a lot of shit that Jake do with wheels and with their cars that these fucking big manufacturers incorporate into their, you remember like before the 90s, these corporations didn't put this on this wheel. Now it's technical standard. It ain't Jake did this shit, man. You know, Jake is a form of all things, man. And that goes ties back to the Jake want to be, makes his hood glorified on the glorified jail. We make everything look good, man. We make property look good, man.
Old block.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Niggas are on the block. In the parking lot of Old Block. Celebrating Ramadan.
But, God, yeah, but see, I'll say this. With all that bullshit bypassing, that's what these Edomites expect you to be.
Yeah, they love okay? You like that. Yep.
So when you got this breath in you, they treat you differently. Because you have a whole different spirit continent on you now. Can you get real quick a wisdom making a man's face to shine? Alright? Hey, shalom, brother. Alright, but so that's why, as the brother would say, he gets it, they treat him differently, man. Okay? Like I said, not all these other camps have that breath of life. That's why, man, you got, going back to what I said earlier, you gotta be, thankful and grateful, okay, every day. Because the Lord, that's what's real scary. The Lord can get you that far and you don't need to run the light.
That's
why you got some scary shit.
You gotta pray that Psalm 51:11, man. Take not the Spirit, the Holy Spirit away from you, man. You know, like you say, you gotta repent every day. You just, hey, that's what it goes into. Begging, man. Just beg the Lord that don't do that. Don't take my hand from the plow, mother, for shot. You know what I'm saying? It's a scary thing because we've seen what happened to our people, man.
The book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 8, verse 1. Who is as the wise man, and who knoweth the interpretation of a thing? A man's wisdom maketh his face to shine, and the boldness of his face shall be changed.
Exactly. So, wisdom, man, get shine on your face, right? Literally changes your structure, man. Because you look, it's funny, right? I'm sure you girls have done this. You look at, like, before the truth pictures of yourself, and then after, and you're like, damn, man, like, you can literally see the change. Like, even me, like, bro, I'm not even that old, man. Look how many grades I got.
Yeah.
I'm 32 years old, man. I got grades like I'm fucking 43.
Wisdom makes a wise man mad. That's what happens.
You know? And, you know, it is what it is, but it changes you. It really does.
Yeah.
Bro, I say pictures like, yeah. Just what? Now even 10 years ago, man. The 6 years, you like, damn, man. El Malcolm, man.
All black.
What's up, brother? How you doing?
What's up, bro?
What's up, bro?
All
crooked.
Yes.
Repent.
Yeah, man. You know,
you
start looking at things different, man. And there's so many, you know, when you start really understanding how terrible this place is, you see how wicked even the smallest of things are, man.
Yeah.
It'll drive you fucking crazy.
Shit like this. Perfect tree. How the fuck is that gonna grow with no other grass around, with concrete around it? Shit like that, man.
Like everything, bro. Like, right now, just on this block, living house to house, that's going on. Hey, shit, we just talked about fucking homes, bro. Now you got the same bitch coming around.
Yeah.
With her fucking booty shorts. That's going on.
Damn, yeah. Lesbian, man.
Walking
around, she got a fucking...
Oh, God, I didn't know that bitch was a lesbian.
Yeah, I didn't know that until you said it, yeah.
This bitch got a fucking son, man, and she's raising him with a fucking stud lesbian.
Hey, you know, man.
Then these chicks wonder how and why all these fucking dudes are pussies, man.
Check this out, too, man. We talked about this actually, man, when was this? It was last week when I had that weird situation happen, so I had to camp down there. We were talking about how these sodomites... Right? They got the highest level of domestic violence.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. Okay. Especially on the lesbian side, it's way higher even than man-on-man violence.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, them stud lesbians be beating the shit out of these hoes, man. And you never see, I never seen that shit on the news once, man.
No, not at all.
Yeah. And I'll say this, I can testify to this, man. So my woman, right, she had a childhood friend, right, and she kindergarten, first grade, whatever, right? And she was, you know, friends with her until recently, right? This bitch is a stud, or not stud, but she's a, you know, lesbian, right? And she deals with, like, the studs and shit. Bitch is fine, man. Clean her ass.
Good.
but point being, though, she ended up having a kid. She had, like, that artificial insemination.
Oh, wow.
So she ended up having this daughter. But the reason why I'm bringing this up is, so my woman would, you know, be telling me, like, yeah, blah, blah, so-and-so called, and she's not even with her fucking lady or whatever. She just tell me about this shit. And I would always tell her, like, man, stop talking to her. Eventually, shit ended up doing it, you know, cutting her off. But I said, look, man, they're bugged out. I gave her all these, you know, different examples and all that. The point being, though, she would tell me numerous times that they be brawling with the two bitches be brawling. Like, and they be fucking up apartments. And they'd have to leave the whole apartment complex because literally cabinets are broken, sinks are broken. And they show you that in a lot of these Instagram and... In TikTok videos, like landlords be showing you how they fuck their place.
And see, that's the thing, man. You never see this shit on the news. But if a dude, nothing don't even gotta happen. A bitch can just call the cops on a dude. No damage to the bitch, no damage to the house. This is not even this bitch house. This dude name on the lease. But she got a pair of shoes in this motherfucker's clothes. Now you gotta leave.
Nigga. Yeah, yeah.
Now you gotta go to jail. Now you a domestic violencer on your record.
And you know, that shit is really happening a lot more too because, hey, these Jakes, even though you may have a young Jake, or just any Jake male, hey, if you ain't the truth, man, hey, you got feminine ways.
That's it.
Real talk. You ain't the truth.
That's it, man.
I mean, look at that kid, right? That was a boy, if I'm mistaken.
Yeah.
He's around two women. They're so, you know, they're in a so-called relationship. You know he's gonna be bugged out, bro.
Yeah.
He's gonna be highly emotional. All he's gonna do is just hit, terrorize shit. Then he's gonna try to look at other men on the, you know, in the neighborhood as an example to how to be a man. And what do you see? Pookie and Ray, right? Just shooting shit up. All right, fighting, selling dope. Come on, bro. It's a vicious cycle, bro. That's why America's got to be destroyed.
That's right.
It's a vicious cycle. It's gonna get worse and worse and worse. So Lord's got to just eliminate this place, bro.
That's right.
Hey, you see how they, I don't know if y'all seen the interview with Andrew Tate, man. With old girl, man. He allowed some reporter to come in his crib and interview. The bitch was trying to take over the whole interview. He bodied her ass, man.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? With just being masculine, man. She was not trying to have it, man. Didn't even shake his hand.
And so this is the thing. He had a real father in his life. You know, I think at a particular time, he ended up living with his mom only. But it was a portion of his life where he grew up with a father. And to my knowledge, he dealt with his father as far as speaking with him and having a relationship throughout his life.
Yeah, yeah,
but see, when you in a situation like that young child is, you know, these women, man, they don't... First of all, both of them bitches bugged out just because they in the world, in America. And then on top of that, they most. So they got a legion of demons on them, man. Because if you're doing that motion, that's like the highest level of wickedness that you can get to.
Yeah, right.
So it's a whole other slew of demons that these bitches got on them that's underneath the mold demon.
Legion.
You know what I'm saying? And then when you're dealing with people like that, they get offended when a man try to be a man. This young kid is gonna be coming up trying to let his nuts hang.
Yeah.
And they already are neutering the child mentally right now.
Damn.
As a young kid, so that when he get older, now he's gonna be a mo, man. Or just a soft, wild dude, like how they was talking about selling drugs and killing niggas and shit.
A brute beast, man.
Just because a nigga says something to you. Stop.
Right. You're right. As you say, it's a brute beast because his inner man is fighting to get out of that effeminate ass spirit. So he just like, fuck it, I'm just gonna wild the fuck out. He turned hopeless. You know what I'm saying? Hey, but you know what though? That thing, the water Yahabashim Yahshai for us, giving us the spirit to understand reincarnation.
That's
his luck. They put that little nigga back into.
That's
man.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
That's it. And like the brother said, you know, it's a vicious cycle. And that's why, you know, you will look at certain of these bitches and you will wonder in your head, like, man, how the fuck is somebody knocking this bitch up? Whose idea was it to knock this bitch up? But you gotta understand something, man. When you growing up, you know, a lot of times, man, if the Lord don't have mercy on you, the type of woman you're going to be looking for is the type of woman that your mama is, man.
Yeah, kind.
And a lot of these niggas' mamas ain't shit.
Kind.
So they end up dealing with bitches that ain't shit. Because they believe that that's what a real... Well, my mom, because you know how Jake is. They'll never say their mama wasn't a real woman. Well, my mama was like this, so if the bitch ain't like this, then I don't want her.
Yeah.
That's how these niggas be. You ask these niggas, they like dealing with raggedy bitches like that.
Kind.
You know?
Kind. Because you common sense will tell you, just like a child that get molested, common sense will tell you, I want some total opposite of that. I don't want to fuck with that. Yeah. That shit is love. You know what I'm saying?
Out.
My mom, when she acted, I don't want no woman. I want a woman opposite of that. You know what I'm saying? But you know what will happen? He get a woman opposite of mom, his mama run the bitch away.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Because
they think that's their man. These women think that their son is their motherfucking man.
Yeah, they're trying to sabotage his life. Sabotage the... dad's
life,
now they're trying to sabotage your son's life,
just
like your motherfucking dad.
That's that nigga shit, man.
That shit, man. But
that's,
I got a few
nigga shit.
But give real quick, we can snooze it. I got this is Psalms 83. And 5, they know not, neither will they understand. They walk on in darkness, all the foundations of the earth are out of course. And that was a perfect example, man. Like we said, you had one stud, super skinny. I thought it was a dude, literally. It literally looks like a guy.
Yeah.
All right? Which is some super thick-ass bitch. And then, what is he, like 7, 8 years old,
on
a scooter.
That's
messed up, bro.
This bitch still is dealing with men.
Oh, definitely.
She's walking outside with this stud as like a fuck you to her baby daddy. This is just a disrespect to man that she got to deal with. This bitch is still fucking doing this, man.
Definitely, bro.
Confusion. These bitches can't even be moles right, man.
Hey, that bitch is fucking the dude with the ski mask that can do across the street.
Oh,
yeah. With a strap on. Moaning with a strap on.
You know, but the foundations of the earth are out of course. All
right?
It says here in Isaiah 5 and 20, woe unto them that call evil good and good evil, that put darkness for light and light for darkness, that put bitter for sweet and sweet for bitter. Woe unto them that are wise in their own eyes and prudent in their own sight. So that's what we see right now. Hey, evil is called good. Good is called evil. All right, these people are wise in their own eyes. Okay? And this is why you see what you see, man.
That's it.
This is the result of not following the law, statutes, and commandments of Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai.
That's right.
and everybody's miserable, okay? Yeah. Hey, deep down inside, all these people are miserable. They hate their lives. That's why they constantly got to do drugs, drink their life away, okay? Have a bunch of sex, because they're trying to run away from reality.
Right.
Reality is...
that
you're in a fucked up situation, okay? And it's not good. It's not right. Fuck you, shit. Water, brother. You know? And that the only way to get out of it is to... to return to Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, man.
That's right.
But see, they're afraid of change, man.
Yeah.
And as we said before, that requires what?
Discipline.
Discipline, okay? Now you have a standard. Hey, there's laws, rules, regulations, and people don't want to deal with that. They want to continue to please their flesh.
That's
they
right.
want to add sin to sin.
That's right.
Yeah, it is. You know? Motherfuckers sit there and tell you, it takes a village. It takes a village, and then you try to ask them.
Who the fuck is you talking to me?
You came for a reprimand. No, I remember neighbors were with me, bro.
Yeah.
And I was like, I'm not telling my mother she was with me. What she hit you for?
Yeah.
Nah, I'm about to go down there and beat that bitch ass. She'll put her kid on my motherfucking kid.
Exactly.
Don't even know the whole story. No, your kid was a fucking demon, man.
Ain't no neighbors no more. It's a bitch and a bunch of bastards.
Yeah.
That's it.
God. I got one right quick. And this is the whole matter of the whole ordeal right here, man. 2 Chronicles 15 and 30. That whosoever will not seek the Lord, Yahweh power of Israel, should be put to death.
That's yep, right. Yes, sir.
Whether small or great, whether man or woman.
Yep.
All right? So we just going to hit it with the home run scripture. Bases loaded, man. All you niggas outside of the truth, man. All right? Not seeking the Lord, not repenting every day. All right? There it is. Hey, they got for you niggas, man, they done put, this is more money, man, this is more money.
It's you!
And this is more money. Here it is now. Jake don't understand about Issachar being his brother, right?
Yeah.
But they, but a regular Jake, two-third Jake, they see him as another nation, like the poor ass. So they like, oh, how y'all letting the motherfuckers come over here? You giving them $51 million because they're in Chicago because of the...
Jake is fucking hot, man.
And that shit started to rouse Jake up. You know what I'm saying? But he don't know Issachar's our people, man. You know what I'm saying? He definitely don't know nothing about special birds.
Yeah.
You know? So now Jake is getting riled up. So it's like, damn, can't you see that this devil don't give a true fuck about you, man? He put moles over you. He put what y'all think other nations over you. You know what I'm saying?
Ask you one question. I don't want no long speech, I just want to ask you this. I'm 53 years old, I've been 53 years old. Out of my whole life, I've heard every other religion, but this. When you believe in religion, some of the stuff outside of religion, I'm more than that. Why? Because my parents kill you. That's just my religion. But, out of every religion I've heard of, Christianity, Baptist, Islam,
they were out here for some time, too, like this. It looked like they, you know, it did come to other cities like Chicago, but it was very small. And then they ended up leaving, right, if I'm not mistaken. Then they go
they're in Riverdale now. Well, it's different sects.
It's the Israelite church right on Kingston, I think.
Right, this is the church right here. I know what you're talking about, but this is...
But, like I said, I heard of every these. I was in London, you know, like I said, I'm 53. I never heard of that until I got older. I heard of every other church, Baptist, Methodist, Jewish, this and that. What some of the stuff y'all say, I never took the truth.
Now we're in that time period where the Heavenly Father is now making the truth flourish. That's why you didn't hear about it when you were a youngster.
A lot of us is like that.
And I think, you know, it's bothering my mind, you know, because some of the stuff y'all say, I knew it was people I'm
Right.
I was like, man, it took all this time for me to, you know.
The Lord said it that way. The Lord said that because we getting close to the evil.
Right.
That's why the Lord is letting the truth flourish. Now, you got Israelite groups that's not teaching 100% truth. You know, through faith, we believe that we got 100% through scripture to salvation. That's what it's all about.
I listen to my man over there on the track. Not to show I'm lying.
No, it's all good, brother.
I keep saying, anything somebody say to me, I look to that.
We admit that we all been lied to. That's the whole thing. We wave the white flag. This way of American philosophy, right. Babylon, this ain't the way. This is Satan.
Right.
So we like, we step away from that shit now. We like, we done with that. This is our heritage.
Right.
Now, religion. Religion is something that you just do for faith. Right. You just something that is something you do religiously. Like you get up and go to work and say, "What? I'm going to work religiously." So something you do all the time, you know. But they've taken the white man, that's taken everything and twisted everything to confuse us, man. You know what I'm saying? So now we live in these days. You know, it's the Most High Power, the Father, the Son. We got to repent now, man, for all the ways we went on. I know you said the whole back in the day and all that. But all that stuff, they incorporated the Bible with gang shit, you know, the king. That's here in Chicago. That's always been the thing of Chicago. Now you look, you're like, nah, we the real people of the Heavenly Father, of the heavens and the earth, man. Yeah. So now it's time for us to repent. I just want to lay it all out. We just got to repent, come back to Him in truth and sincerity, man. Through the scriptures, man. Believe every word from Genesis to Revelation, man. Through the Spirit. You got to pray for the Holy Spirit, because you can read it all you want. The Holy Spirit ain't dealing with you. Then you through. If you got civil unrest, like, huh? Which is called Jacob's Trouble. Then you hear all the rumors of war. World War III, you might as well say, we here. Hey, you got, and this is pointing this way, so how else other way can you escape out of it? You can't escape with no money. Can't escape with whatever fucking thing you got. Not you personally, but you know what I'm saying? The only way you're going to escape is through the scriptures, man. Through the Holy Spirit, man.
Yeah. I think that microchip, that's what they're going to start personalizing the people. That's the market piece. I don't care what any other Israel, like you said, that's the market piece. Okay, not take that. Don't take that. In the name of the Heavenly Father and the Son of Yahweh, that's the name of the Heavenly Father and the Son of Yahweh Shah. No.
That's how the rest is saying.
So it's Yahweh and Yahweh Shah. Yep, Yahweh and Yahweh Shah. Try to remember that for the rest of you.
And pray and repent.
Okay,
not take
y'all
that chip.
Like me on that.
Brother.
Was really kind of messing with me, because, like I said, I'm 53, and I actually never heard of losing my life and killed. Like I said, I'm 49, 50. But like I said,
This is our heritage, man. This we are physical descendants of the Father and the Son, and He will come back and rescue His elect. Now, it's about the elect. Ain't just about being an Israelite. It's an elect number. Exactly, and that's the elect. So you want to strive for that.
Right there, I just telling somebody, I said, they usually right there, but every time they get right there, they be deep.
Yeah, that's a different, that's a different group of people.
Oh, that's a different group?
Yeah, it's multiple different groups.
It's like almost like how, you know how you got Christianity, you got Roman Catholicism, right, you got Baptist Church.
So y'all different.
Yeah, it's
right.
Yeah. And it's like little, it's like the little things. And those little things are key, like the main thing that don't take that chip. Right. They don't push that.
Right. A lot of them get paid by the white people, just being honest. They get the 501c3. So they can certain shit they can't say, they got a puzzle.
Right, so y'all different.
Yeah.
We start roughly.
So
like,
they can like pull up now to stay there and listen to them.
You said what now?
They can like, when I walk past, they can like force me to stay there. When I look up 40 minutes, man.
Oh, yeah, we ain't on that. When you say you gotta go, you gotta go.
I see that. You know what I'm saying? I asked y'all, because y'all gave me a direct answer. Y'all were trying to pull on it and tell me other things I didn't know. Y'all gave me a little ad.
You come back, we're here Saturday roughly about 3:30, about 5:30, 6 o'clock.
What time y'all leave?
About 6. Yeah.
Maybe
y'all
later.
Be here by what time?
3:30.
I'll be here real fast.
Also, we on, if you watch YouTube, GMS Chicago.
GMS Chicago?
Yeah, Frank Middlestone.
Okay, okay, yeah. Though.
All right, all right, brother. Be safe, brother.
To answer that brother with the scripture, right? Because he asked, how come he's never heard of this, right? Or it took him so long to hear about this, right? This is 2nd Ezra chapter, what is this, chapter 6 and 27. For evil shall be put out and deceit shall be quenched. And that's what's happening right now with this word, okay? Verse 28, as for faith, it shall flourish. Corruption shall be overcome, and the truth, which has been so long without fruit, shall be declared.
That's right.
So the truth, all right? It didn't have fruit for a long time. But see, we're in these latter days, the end times, where the Lord is waking us up. Now, that this is why now you see prophets all over the place, and you see this word getting pushed at an all-time high, okay? Because we're at the end, you know?
Hey, I got one right quick. This is Isaiah 29 and 18. And in that day shall the deaf hear the words of the book. So, hey, that brother, at one time he was deaf, one time we was all deaf, right? And the eyes of the blind shall see out of obscurity. Going back to what we was across the street talking about, the darkness and light, you know? And out of darkness, the meek shall also increase their joy in the Lord, and the poor men among the poor among men shall rejoice in the Holy One of Israel.
I was going to say, the ones who are going to receive this word are the meek, the humble, those who have a contrite spirit.
That's right.
Okay? As you can tell, man, he's been through stuff.
Yeah,
hurting. Yeah. Okay? Yeah. You can tell, he, you know, he's for the most part, he's a pretty humble dude, man.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
All right?
Hey, man, and a lot of, you know, he's somebody that, and I don't know the brother, so I, you know, this is just all off of just this small interaction. But he seemed like somebody that really just got a hunger for wanting to know what the truth is, wanting knowledge. You know what I'm saying?
Because he touched on every group or religious group. He looked into everything. You could tell, hey, he humbled, but you could tell, hey, that was a Jake not to be fucked with him.
Oh, yeah, he wasn't going.
Yeah, you know, that Jake there, he still kind of got a little bit of stature to him somewhat, man. You know what I'm saying? Now he like, look here, what's the deal, man?
Yeah.
I need to know what's up. And then right there, his spirit recognized. He said, oh, y'all not like the other trying to keep me in all that. We let the spirit deal how the spirit deal, man.
Can't force the forces of the river, as the scripture says.
That's right. Because a lot of these other camps, man, they just a gimmick. They a gimmick group, man. They get on camera and they do shit for shock value. So Jake will come up and start asking questions. And instead of answering the Jake, now it's different if you going into a certain subject and the Jake come up and you want to finish what you was talking about at first, then you deal with Jake. But a lot of these camps, you know, just from watching videos of other Jakes, like in these different camps, a Jake will come up and have a question, and these niggas, instead of answering the question directly, they want to rip Jake because he's dressed a certain way, or they want to say, well, you got lying in.
Tell
you why this is wrong.
Why
right
you done with the Morse,
instead of just answering the brother's question first, and then if the spirit bring you to the situation of cutting him for this or cutting him for that. Because see, this is the thing, man. We like doctors for these people, man. And that's to say that humbly. when you go into the doctor's office, man, before they try to put you under the knife and do some surgery, they're gonna try to help you out without having to do that first. Yeah. But see, these dudes, they go and deal with these other camps, and these niggas, well, we gotta cut your leg off before we go anywhere. Yeah. We gotta cut this leg off first.
That's a great analogy,
you know.
Man.
And that's not really how this works, man. And you can really because the Lord is gonna hold you accountable if you are given this knowledge and you are allowed to teach. Even if you're being sincere and you send somebody off like that, you're going to be held accountable for that, man. Because you don't know who's sincere and who's not sincere.
That's right.
And at the end of the day, the Lord, you know, if the Lord wants him to get it, he'll get it. If you don't, he don't. But you still got to carry this a certain way, man. You still got... See, our performance is not contingent on how other people act. It's contingent on how we act and how we do things.
Right.
If you doing shit the wrong way, whether this dude get it or don't get it, it's irrelevant. Because you're not teaching things properly. And when Jake come and ask sincere questions like that, and you cutting the nigga because he don't got a beard, before you answer his question, like, you know, the brother's obviously in ignorance. That's why he don't got this or he don't got that. Jake be trying to pull splinters out of people's eyes, and they got folks in their own eye, man, and that's not how it goes. But I got a quick one real quick to land back on what the brother said about the question that the brother asked. This is the book of Daniel, chapter 12, verse 1. And at that time shall Michael stand up, the great prince was standing for the children of thy people. And there shall be a time of trouble, such as never was since there was a nation, even to the same time. And at that time thy people shall be delivered, everyone that shall be found written in the book. And many of them that sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake, some to everlasting life, and some to shame and everlasting contempt. And they that be wise shall shine as the brightness of the firmament, and they that turn many to righteousness as the stars forever and ever. But thou, O Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book, even to the time of the end, many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall be increased. So like the elder brother brought out, you know, this knowledge was sealed up for a certain period of time so that things could happen the way that they have happened for the sake of the story, so to say. But now that we at the time of the end and we come in, because right now we still are in a time that's never been seen before. Like the elder Yock say, it just get more wicked every day.
Shit.
Now, we aren't at the worst yet, but it's still, the shit that's going on here is worse than anything that was going on in any of these other times. In any of these other civilizations, and it's only going to get worse. So now that we're coming up to that point where it's going to reach the climax or the crescendo, as they say, the Lord has taken the seals off the book so that those who he has chosen to get the knowledge, Lord willing, will be of that number, and those he chose to endure to the end, now it's time for them to get understanding to be able to deal with what's coming, you know? But it's a lot of lessons that had to be learned without having the knowledge, man.
Yeah.
Because it's a lot of situations that you will find yourself in when you was in the world, that if you was in the truth, you would never have encountered that situation.
That's right.
You know?
That brother came up there, like, he kind of gave us like a, I ain't for the long speech and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
There, which is cool. You know, because what we gave him the name.
And that's in the scriptures, man. Keep it simple with a lot of these jakes, man. That's the problem that a lot of these other camps got too. Like I said, it's just a gimmick for them. It's like a WWF wrestling promo.
They just
want to, because they get this how they do it.
They
record themselves ripping jakes, ripping Edomites, and that's how they get niggas to, niggas watch that shit like entertainment.
Fun.
Man.
Yeah, that's the fun.
You know?
Yeah, that's why Sonetta and them type of cats use us now and try to follow, get on the coattail, so to speak, because that's the new thing. Israelites, the new thing that's popping. What we do, we gave the brother the name. We told him America's getting ready to be destroyed. You know what I'm saying?
Don't take the chip.
You
and I mean? Promise you, them niggas that he was talking about didn't say nothing about none of that, man.
Look, black
they
man.
They told the nigga, they...
You know, they got it. Look, black man.
They told the nigga a bunch of irrelevant shit that the nigga was doing wrong.
Like how you say, you can't live for Christmas.
Sometimes, you
you just gotta be, you know, straight to the point, quote a couple of scriptures, you go from there, man. That's like, look, man, you can't, look, sometimes you just gotta plant the seed quickly.
You can't
sit there and, hey, let me try to nurse it too much, man. Right. Talk about how one can only eat herbs, basically. Some can eat that meat. Look, man, a guy like that, he just needs some, a couple pieces of lettuce, so to speak.
Yeah. You know, some spinach.
All right, that's what he can eat. He can't eat a goddamn chicken breast. He can't eat a New York steak.
Yeah, steak. Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? No, that's too much for him. All right?
I got one.
Yep.
Oh, if I may.
Yeah, it's fine.
This is Ezekiel 33:6. But it, I started 4. From the top. Ezekiel 33:1. Again, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Son of man, speak to the children of thy people, and say unto them, when I bring the sword upon the land, if the people of the land take a man of their coats and set him for their watchman, if when he see the sword come upon the land, he blow the trumpet and warn the people. That's what we're doing right now. That's the gentleman that came up, right? Then whosoever hears the sound of the trumpet, he's like, I've been hearing over there. I see y'all over there last week. Y'all gonna be, you know, he hearing it. And take not the warning, if the sword come and take him away, his blood shall be upon his own head. So if that man don't, this we go off the scripture, if that man don't want to receive it, oh, fuck it, well, we told him, right?
Yeah.
We going off the scripture. Verse 5, he heard the sound of the trumpet, he heard the sound of the trumpet and took not warning, his blood shall be upon him, but he that taketh warning shall deliver his soul. But if the watchman see the sword come and blow not the trumpet, and the people not be warned. See, them other groups ain't blowing the trumpet. They telling them all kind of other bullshit that don't matter, right? If the sword come and take any person from among them, he is taken away in his iniquity. But if his blood will I require at the watchman's hand. So them other groups, man, you ain't giving people the right food. Like you say, to plant the right seeds immediately, you know, skillfully, you know, with a little, you know, season, a little salt. Hey, man. You're gonna be through, man. That's on your head, man.
I got some too. Because when you plant something, right? Say this, if you overwater a plant, you can kill it. Like, right? This is Deuteronomy 32:2.
Deuteronomy 32:1.
Give ear, O ye heavens, and I will speak, and hear, O earth, the words of my mouth. My doctrine shall drop as the rain. My speech shall distill as the dew, as the small rain upon the tender herb, and the showers upon the grass. And remember, some of these individuals, especially somebody that just heard this for the first time, they're a tender herb. They can't deal with the heavy rainfall, so to speak. They just need the little showers, all right?
Hey, that's why he went to this camp, because he's like, I don't want to go over there. There's too many of them. I don't feel like, Jake want to get straight to the point.
Exactly. And then, man, look how he was saying, because I believe, if I'm not mistaken, I could be wrong, I believe ISUPK once in a while actually camps over here. Maybe IUIC, but I believe it's ISUPK. And like how we were saying, these guys want you to stay for an hour and tell you, look, black man, this is what it is. The white man and the black man, because that's all you hear too. I got to emphasize this.
Yeah.
You know?
Man. Asking niggas if they smoke cigarettes.
Yeah, you know, it's with fucking shades on, bro.
Heckling people.
Yeah, that's what they're doing, man. Like you say, it's the shock value, man. You get a hit now.
Yeah, see, this is the thing with that, man. I'm all for shame being a tactic to get people right, but it's a time and a place to pull that out. You know, homo. You don't this, when somebody's just walking up like that, man, like the brother said, and this might be his first time getting exposed to this. No shit, this nigga's going to be going off, man. How was you moving before you came to the truth, bro?
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
And a lot of these dudes, man, they got the job description fucked up. You know, like the scriptures say, you're supposed to plant the seed, and you can even water the seed. But it's the Lord that's going to decide whether this dude gets it or not. But these jakes, they want to make you get it. They want to shame you into getting it. And that's not how it works,
that's
man.
Their pride.
It's almost like damn near every bit, because it's crazy. Not that I've watched. I'll say this. I've watched enough videos of the ISUPK in particular. Sometimes, a lot of times, IUIC does it too, but I'll say ISUPK in particular. All they do is just put you down, bro.
Yeah.
Like, damn, bro, I just showed up. I'm trying to figure out what's going on.
Yeah. Yeah.
Never heard of this before. I may have seen it once or twice. You know, been on the news, on Instagram. You know what I'm saying?
But you know what? The Lord is working in all things. You know? If you don't want somebody to get it, he'll send your ass to him.
But this is for brothers who are teaching, who are trying to, pump true names of Yahweh, Shah, the true doctrine. You gotta learn how to deal with people. Hey, get real quick the reasoning of men.
You know what, too? Yeah, that's why you gotta be, Paul said, to be a man well traveled. And you gotta know how to read spirits, man. Before he walked up, I knew Jake, gang banged back in the day and all that kind of stuff. I don't know that brother from a can of paint, but you can just tell by his whole setup, Jake been out here, man. You know what I'm saying? Read people's spirits, man. That's through the Holy Spirit, man. I'm not saying that privately,
It's the true doctrine. That's the spirit that I call for that scripture. Because when the brother's going to get this in the psalm, if you can't find it, I'm going to find it. It talks about wisdom, right? And it basically gives you a breakdown on what wisdom taught King Solomon. And one of them is the reasoning of men.
Yeah.
Meaning, you understand how men think. Okay, why they think like this.
Yeah.
We mentioned earlier, not every camp has what? The breath of life, man. Not every camp has that wisdom. So, they don't know how to interact with individuals. Yeah. That's why they're all bugged out, man.
Yeah.
You know? You see? Alright? And the scriptures also too, because you mentioned Apostle Paul, he said, I became all things for all men, roughly paraphrasing.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes you gotta get on the lower level, so to speak.
Right,
you know what I'm saying?
Right.
You don't always have to be at this higher level and always
put the medicine in the trenches.
Right?
And like you said, it's really a pride thing that you want, Jake.
To be honest, man.
You don't know the question that these people got to ask you could be something that will lead to some real edification that a lot of people got questions about, man. You know? The question that he'll act like, we wasn't even talking about this before that dude walked up. We was talking about something completely different. But the Spirit brought him over here to change the subject. And when you are trying to force feed somebody and you don't let them ask their question, it's a lot of things that I have knowledge about, but it won't come out because it's not in your mind to bring that out, but the question to bring it out. But this is what the brother called for. This is the wisdom of Solomon, chapter 7 and verse 17. For he hath given me certain knowledge of the things that are, namely, to know how the world was made and the operation of the elements. The
operation of the elements. Keep going.
The beginning, ending, and midst of the times.
That's heavy. So King Solomon knew what happened at the beginning. And what's going to happen at the end. All right?
That's
heavy, bro. Just keep going.
The alterations of the turning of the sun.
Remember, the sun and the moon are for a time. To read times, okay, as the scriptures talk about.
Right.
And we used to have a lot of knowledge in the ancient world of these things, especially the tribe of Issachar. Okay? You know, I'll tell you that in the Second Chronicles and all that.
And even Esau will tell you that in his own secular history.
Yeah,
they credit the Mayans with being the first people that track time. Let me continue. This wisdom of Solomon, chapter 7 and verse 18, the beginning, ending, midst of the times, the alterations of the turning of the sun and the change of seasons, the circuits of years and the positions of stars, the natures of living creatures, and the furies of wild beasts.
So basically, King Solomon, he knew about nature, man. And that's something our people run away from.
Right.
Like you take them to a forest preserve, and like, this is boring.
Yeah.
Like, damn, bro, our forefathers were intrigued by the wild. They were intrigued by the animals, how rivers flow, the currents. Okay. You know, the seasons, you know, so on and so forth.
That's right. Go back to, like you said, but Jake said, it's too quiet out here. You know, the hell that sound.
Yeah. Wow. Going out. The violence of winds and the reasoning of men.
The reasoning of men, okay? So that's what wisdom teaches you, man. How to deal with people. How they think, why they think like this. You see?
And that's why the Lord brings in all manner of men as far as we're the hopeful elect. You know, but he brings in different matter of men from all different range lifestyle. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
You may have a brother that he can hear under Elder Malcolm or Elder Yashawamba, and he's like, they like, oh, okay, I get that. When you get a rougher brother, you know what I'm saying? He may be cussing a lot, rough around the edges, and a young Jacob may understand, like, I like this brother.
I like the time.
Yeah.
Straight up, bro.
Yeah, come on, man.
I like how he curse out them black bitches.
Oh, shit, then he's saying this, too. Oh, this got to be some validity to what this brother's saying. Yeah. Boom, there you go. He got it. Yeah. You know?
Yeah, it's getting in my head.
Just cut right to the point,
you bitches.
Hey, the Lord is working a wonder, because, look, the Lord can set it up where you come up, and he stepped to him, and he hear him tell you, oh, that ain't never the truth. You talking about, I'm out of here. Boom, you just damn yourself.
Look at our camp, man. We got brothers who are in their 50s, 60s, brothers in their, 20s.
All ranges.
You know what I'm saying? Brothers from different tribes, different backgrounds. It's heavy, bro.
Yeah, man. But it's important to have that, like the brother said, you gotta be able to read situations. And even, taking that Jake out of the equation, Lord willing, he get his mind right, but even if he don't, it's somebody that needed that question answered, man.
Yeah.
And these other groups, like the brother Matazaki was saying, instead of tearing a Jake down, well, I already know you're going off, bro.
Yeah.
We all going off. Let's just be clear. We doing it to the best of our ability, trying not to. Right. But we all going off, man. So why these other camps even harking on shit that niggas is doing that's still in the world don't even make sense to me, man.
Yeah.
Now if a nigga walk up to the line and he's smoking while you teaching, or he light a blunt while you teaching, that's different.
Right.
But when Jake got sincere questions, and then that's another thing, when you can read men and read situations, you know when somebody being sincere or when somebody coming up to scoff, man.
Yeah, that the brother was sincere, man.
You know?
Yeah, definitely.
He was seeking and searching. Hey, because that goes right to that Romans 11:7. He was, Israel have not obtained that which he seek. Oh, that man seek. He said, I went over there. I come over here. Y'all see it. And he saw the other groups. He's like, oh, that's not y'all. You know, because once you come into this Israel thing, you're like, oh, we all know Israelites, so we good. Yeah. And then you you like, oh, shit, that's different.
I mean, it's the spirit, because before that Jake walked up, the brother Nadazaki has said, a lot of these other Jakes, they got the flesh on their bones, but they don't got the breath of life. And it sounds like you ran into some just like that.
Yeah, yeah.
And Lord willing, them dudes get their mind right too. Because, the Apostle Har always say that a lot of these Jakes in these other camps is of the elect as well. They just in a different situation right now, but Lord willing, whoever that is, they gonna get delivered out of that. But yeah, man, you gotta be careful, man, because it starts turning into a gimmick. It starts turning into, and see, Esau, like the brother had brought out, Esau set it up to where all these groups that's got 501c3s, they gotta be raunchy like that.
Yeah,
they gotta be wild. They gotta be extra, because the truth is polarizing in and of itself, but they gotta be extra disrespectful and polarizing with it.
And it's like, basically, how was the Elder Yashua, I know you put it in the disciples room, how he was saying that these other camps thinking, like, you basically using wisdom is like an effeminate trait,
yeah,
it's really not. It's actually very masculine.
Yeah.
Right. You know?
Right. Right.
You got to apply wisdom and use it, man. Okay? Not every situation calls for you being, you know, a mighty man, so to speak.
That's right.
Sometimes you got to be, you know, a little bit more relaxed, calm, okay, cool, collective, you know? See, yeah. These guys, they got to portray the image. We're tough, you know, fucking, you know, we ain't no weak team. There we go. I came up, knew it. It took me a second to, you know, remember that. But that's what they said. I ain't no weak Jew. Like, come on, bro.
A lot of that shit got an effeminate aroma behind it, man.
The end
that's
of the day,
what's
yeah.
going on, man. You know, motherfuckers just can't be chill. Because, you know, back in back in the day, Jake was more so chill and relaxed and smooth, man. You know, smooth operators.
Yeah.
You know,
When you got a father, you learn to be like that, man. And a lot of these, now with like the brother matters, like you said earlier, the cycle is so vicious that most of these Jakes don't got a father, but even the ones that do, they father a bitch ass thing anyway. And so you just learning how to emotionally react. You're not learning how to respond mentally. You're not learning how to respond through the spirit, which is all things that you will learn in the truth.
Hey, and even like, you know, back in the day, if a cat didn't have a father, hey, it was other men around him that showed you a way of somewhat, you know what I'm saying? Nobody might not live in a house with you, but if still you had an uncle, you know what I'm saying, a brother or something, that kind of, your grandfather or something like that, to show you. These days, hey, nobody, that's how you know you have to eat.
I got a quick one before we close it up.
The last scripture was still dropping in Africa, so try to make it quick.
It's the book of Proverbs, chapter 18. In verse 21, death and life are in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof. You know? So you got to be wise on how you're dealing with people and how you're speaking to people, man, because there's consequences behind everything. Even if that particular individual don't do nothing to you, you know, the Lord's still going to get you for whatever it is that you do if he sees fit. All right?
That's it. All right, well, with that, you know, hopefully this is an edifying one. And then, you know, we're going to end it off, as always, by giving all praises, honor, and glory to
Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashem, Rakakadash.
Double honor to the apostles and the elders of the great millstone. Salutations to all your brothers out there. Shalom and Ababa Ba.
Ababa Ba.